Are you wanting to live stream directly to your website? Maybe you're running a special event or some sort of fundraiser, but you want to really control that experience and maybe offer either as a free event directly on your site or with ticket sales. Well, how can you do that? We're going to talk about today the best solution I found in order to live stream directly to your site. Hello and welcome. I'm Nick Polkowski, and on this channel, we talk all about live streaming and videography and how you can use those to grow your business. And in today's episode, we're going to talk about how you can actually go live directly to your website with a really cool service that's out there. And this is going to be perfect for those of you that have, say, some sort of ticketed event that you want to charge for and go live directly on your site, or you just want to, maybe you're doing some sort of fundraising event or some big special event that you want. Don't just want to have on social media, but you also want to control on your own website as a way to get people back to your site and start engaging with your brand that way versus just relying on the reach of Facebook or YouTube or something like that. So let's jump in and talk a little bit about this service. We're going to be specifically talking about Caster. Now, I did a previous video, you can check it out right here, all about Caster's multicasting service, which is really great. It allows you to go to multiple different platforms at the same time. But with their live streaming plan, you're actually going to be able to go directly to your website, have kind of that embedded player that's going to be able to play directly on your site. So let's jump in and see just what Caster is all about. Now, here you can see I am inside, I've signed in to Caster. And again, I am on their live streaming plan. They have their multicasting plan and they have their live streaming plan. The slight difference, there's a few different differences, but mainly the one we want to focus on is that their live streaming plan allows you to live stream directly to their site, where their multicaster is all about going to multiple different platforms. Now, with their live streaming plan, you can also live stream to multiple different platforms, but you're going to be able to have that embedded player that you can go directly on their site. So we're going to go here and click Create New Stream. And again, we want not new multicasting stream, we want new live stream because it gives you your own embedded player. That's the key difference here. So we're gonna select that and let's go Caster Test Stream. And then I'm gonna go ahead and select US Central because I am here in Madison, Wisconsin. So the central region. All right, so here we are. And again, if you wanna hit over here, you can add all of these other platforms, which is really great, can be really useful. I have a full video on how to do that right here. Just click this one, it'll walk you through everything for that. So we're gonna skip that right now. And what we're gonna look at right here is how to actually go ahead and set up everything for their streaming plan, for their streaming service, so we can embed it directly on our site. Now, first thing we're gonna do is set up our streaming element. I'm gonna go ahead and grab this right here. This is the deployment region, and this is the streaming URL. So with that, we're gonna go into our third-party system, which is, we're gonna be using Ecamm right here. So you can see this is the camera for Ecamm, and I have it up here. Camera's not super set up super well, but I wanted to have separate cameras here so we can just make sure to get everything exactly the way we want it. Now, let's go ahead and add new stream. I'm gonna go ahead, because we're changing some of this, this was for that previous video. But there we have the RTMP there. We're going to copy the stream key and paste and use custom stream key. And now we're all set up. We have our custom stream key ready to go. And I'm gonna go ahead and hit go live, just so you can kind of see how this is all working. We're gonna kind of build this one step at a time. You're not necessarily gonna wanna go live right away, but I wanna make sure I show you every element of this. So we're going live, let's get this out of the way. That is for that. And you can see after a few seconds, because there will be a delay, there's always gonna be a delay when you're streaming. So you're going to notice some of that here, but there's a small, slight delay, but we can see we are fully live. We have our preview window right here. This is what the preview window looks like. But now it's time to go ahead and put this on our website. So let's go ahead and jump on in to our sites. All right, so here we are behind the scenes on one of my websites. I'm gonna go ahead and create a page and that we're gonna use to embed this. We're gonna create something super simple, super basic, and you can easily add in multiple different layers. If I was creating an event page, I would add several different layers, including the URL. It would say it's a multi-day conference, or even if it's a couple hour conference, you might wanna have a schedule in there, something like that. So you're gonna wanna decide what layers you're gonna be adding. I like the theme Divi. You're gonna see that's what I use for all of this. If you want a link to Divi, you wanna check that out, just check the link in the description. I'll also include kind of right here, nickpolkowski.com/Divi. It really is one of my favorite themes. I use it to build all the websites. So let's go ahead and use the Divi Builder. We're just gonna start building from scratch because I just need kind of this basic piece in order to show you what we're going to be building, and I'm going to go ahead and add the text in. All right, and we're going to go here and jump back to, we're back in Caster now. You can see we're still streaming, and you can see it's at 30 frames per second. You can see the resolution, you can see the bit rate. Obviously we have no viewers because we're not live anywhere yet. So I'm going to go ahead and grab the iframe widget. And if you jump back into this here, I'm gonna go paste that. All right, so here's kind of just an example of what that page looks like. It has the player embedded right there. And again, this is the iframe that we use to add that here. And you can pause and stop it, full screen. You can make any sort of adjustments that you want. And right there is your player. Now they also have the option to, rather than use an iframe, you can use the embedded URL. So I'm gonna grab the embedded URL and we're gonna tap there. And you can see right there, then you get kind of that full screen. If you just wanna send somebody directly to your live stream with nothing else around it, you're okay with the caster IO being there, you can just share that URL. It's gonna take you right here so you kind of see that. So again, Caster is really something that I enjoy. I really like the way it's set up, especially in this live streaming aspect. It just allows you to do so much in terms of creating the environment for your live event. This is gonna get you out of that kind of social media, Facebook, YouTube driven world where it has to be exactly the way they look. You can't really do a lot of customization around it. You have to be on their platforms and driven through Twitch and LinkedIn and stuff like that. This way, you're gonna be able to take some control of it, and it might be a great way, especially if you have, say, an older audience, if you are an audience that doesn't have, you know, those Facebook accounts, those YouTube accounts, but you wanna create the best experience for them, you can grab and use this plan to direct it right to your website. You can drive all the traffic there, but then you still have the flexibility with Caster of being able to send it out to multiple different platforms without having the load, the bandwidth load by trying to individually send it out. You can send one stream out to Caster and then Caster will take care of the rest and send it out to the entire, however many places you wanna send it out to. They have several different options there and lots of flexibility in their plan. The other thing I really like about Caster is just its super simple interface. So you basically set things up and then you send it. And then as long as it's going through, you can kind of send it here. I do want to run through a couple more things. They do have some analytics here. So you can see concurrent viewers, things like that. You can see player hits. So the number of times people have hit that that player, that embedded player. And you can break down some of your analytics there. Obviously, with a stream that's going up to no one, we're not going to have a lot there. These are just a couple pages that I have opened is the reason while recording this is the reason we're getting some hits there. You can do recordings. So I could record the streams and you can see they'll be recorded directly. Recordings now enabled, so I could go ahead and record right from there if I wanted to. You also have the option, this is really cool, and this is what I'm talking about when I'm saying you can really customize things, is you can change the theme of the player. So we could change it so the player is slightly different themed. We can enable passwords protection on your stream. This is, again, if you're selling a ticket, for example, if you're doing a ticketed live event, this is where this is super powerful. You can have that password there. Only send it out to the people you want to be able to send it out to who have paid for that event. It's really awesome. Enable autoplay. I like to leave that on. I like things, especially if it is a live stream event, you want people to be able to see that right away. So that's where I like to have that enabled. And then you can even add Google Analytics. You can enable multi-bit rate transcoding if you want to. Enable chat. This is really cool. If you want to keep everything within Caster. Now, this is in beta, so I don't want to necessarily talk too much about it. But I think I really love the fact that they're adding this feature because right now, a lot of times what I end up doing is with events, I will create a whole separate chat role, and that just kind of lives underneath the embedded player. And it's just an extra step, extra little hassle, and it's two different services. So the fact that they are now creating that chat feature, love it. And then you can change the thumbnail, basically, is what this is. You can also enable a watermark. If you want your brand logo, like a little bug here over in the corner, you can add that and it'll play on your, it'll show up on your player so people always know who it's coming from. And it's just a nice little subtle touch to add that extra little bit of branding, especially when you have it kind of, I like to have it either white or at least a little bit transparent, just so it's kind of there, not too intrusive, but it's a great way to add that little extra little bit of professionalism to your streams. Last little bit, there's the security section here. This is where you're going to enable password protection. You can block certain countries. You can whitelist so that only people from certain areas are able to watch your stream. And you can also enable domain whitelisting, which will basically allow you to only have that embedded playlist playing on specific domains. So nobody else is going to be able to play it on a different website or steal your content. This is just another extra little security level that Caster has in, especially, again, this is great if you are doing ticketed live events. Biggest reason I think to check some of this out is if you're doing those ticketed events, it's going to add that extra element of security, but have a really streamlined ease of use. There's other services I've used out there that can be more difficult to get up and running. The interface can just be a little more clunky and not as smooth and just not as nice as what Caster allows you to do here, which is why I love them. And then the last thing I want to showcase here is, it is, again, hit this several times, but it is just that super simple interface. So really all you have to do if you want to disable the stream from this end, like, so we have our stream kind of running here. I could always finish it here and stop it on the actual third-party streamer end, but third-party switcher end. But if I want to disable it directly from Caster, say we're logged in there or whatever, I just want to shut things off to all the different streams that are happening, all I have to do is hit disable, and then you can see we've disabled the stream so I can quickly shut it down. And then even if I do want to bring it back in, I am able to do that right from here. It doesn't necessarily stop the stream. The stream's still maintained, so I can easily re-enable it. So this is great if you have to, you know, quickly shut something down, or I wouldn't necessarily recommend disabling the stream if you're just going on a break. I like to add, say, in Ecamm, add some sort of element that showcases that we're on a break, we'll be back in this time, so some sort of graphic, something like that. That's how I'd recommend going on a break, but if you need to, for whatever reason, you are able to do it on this end, which I think is great. And that's really all there is here to do. There's not a lot else to do, so it's a super simple, super clean interface. So again, highly recommend you check out Caster. Head on over to nickpolkowski.com/caster and look at their live streaming plan. I think this is a plan that a lot of people who are watching this channel, a lot of you out there, would really benefit from and could really use because of the flexibility it gives you with your live stream. So if you want to learn more about Caster and just their multicasting service, check out this video right here. If you're just getting started with YouTube live video, be sure to check out this playlist right here. And don't forget to subscribe, and I will see you in the next video.